Hey guys, Nate here again. I'm going to be doing another episode of Bad at Card Games where I play Hearthstone and in the future other card games like Magic Online, and I am bad at them, but try really hard to get better and talk through all my plays and hopefully because of that become a better gamer and maybe a better person in time. This is just a standard combo or druid, whatever you want to call it, deck. It's really just net deck straight from Hearthpwn from a guy named Colma. And you can just look it up on Hearthpwn right now. It's one of the most popular druid decks on the list. It's very similar to the previous combo druid decks in that it revolves a lot around having sticky minions and the big combo damage of having Savage Roar and Force of Nature, giving you a 14 damage combo on turn 9. This deck is a little bit different, mildly so. Also, just both of the combo decks in general, the old one and the new one, also have this awesome Power of the Wild. Give your minions 1/1 or summon a 3/2 Panther, and Violet Teacher synergy, which summons just a 1/1 token whenever you cast a spell. Great for just getting awesome board presence. Lots of sticky creatures in here, like the Haunted Creeper. When it dies, it gives you some tokens. Harvest Golem is a token generator. Slug Belcher is a token generator. Cairn Bloodhoof is a big token generator. Cenarius, token generator. Or give all your guys to +2/+2 for the big combo finish, or just for massive amounts of board control. The slight difference in this new deck I've noticed is, of course, the addition of the Noxoramus expansion cards. Things like Lotheb to slow down Miracle Rogues and Nerevar Weblord to slow down anything that has Battle Cry. There's no Battle Cry in this deck, so it has no effect on me. Things like the Druid of the Claws, choose one, charge, or +2 health and taunt are not counted as Battle Cries. So that's pretty neat. And it's also taken out one Force of Nature in favor for more sticky minions. So this is much more what feels like a flexible deck. Less all in on you getting the combo, less reliant on you getting the combo, and more about getting a bunch of dudes on the board, hitting them with Power of the Wild, hitting them with Savage Roar, and swinging into his face for tons and tons of damage. So, alright. I just tried to record a segment, got halfway through a game, and realized two things. One, I was still playing my Ramp Druid deck. I've got to change decks down here to the Combo Wombo deck. And also, my mic was off, so we get a chance to redo, reset, and go again. The game wasn't that special. It was just me missing the ramp as Ramp Druid and getting killed by a Zoot deck. Pretty standard. So, and with now we're ready to go, let's put on some music. Put on some bluegrass. I really like bluegrass. This band in particular is a lot on this playlist. This band in particular is called the Harmed Brothers. So I'm following Colma's mulligan strategy. He says Innervate, Weblord, Haunted Creeper, Wrath, Power of the Wild, Harvest Golem. So let's see. Haunted Creeper and the other two are going to get mulliganed out. Playing against a warrior. I've been seeing a lot of aggro and control warrior recently, which is, it's fresh to see. For the longest time, it was all about control warrior, and they throw down the their legendary, I can't remember its name, but it's the one that you can enrage and it swings for 10 or 12 damage or whatever. Grommish Hellscream, I think, is the name if I remember correctly. This was an armor smith. I used to think this was indicative that it was going to be a control warrior deck, because control warriors usually rely on having a lot of armor. But I've been proven wrong the past few days. So go ahead and throw out our little two drop. This deck's pretty light on the early drops. Let me send a message. Alright, and I'm back to paying attention. So I don't know what we're gonna do on turn 3 here. We can't trade efficiently at all with the Armor Smith. Yep, don't really have a play here, so we're just gonna peck him for 2. For the best. Turn 4, Violet Teacher, into turn 5, swiping and a big threat. Seems like it's going to be a good play. Or just turn 4 Violet, turn 5 Druid, because this is all about getting guys on the board. Guys on the board is what we want. Okay, this is now resembling a bit more the good old Control Warrior. Alright. Okay, cool. We got the Power of the Wild. Part of me is tempted to burn a swipe here just to clear the Armored Smith. That seems very wasteful. If he devotes both these guys into killing this, he gains a little bit of armor and gains a card, but I get two tokens out. And because of the chance of me getting tokens out, I'm going to go ahead and play the Violet Teacher. If he burns removal to kill this, that's fine, because that's removal that's not going to be hitting our fancy golden druid of the claws. And if he has no response whatsoever, then we're just going to go nuts with Power of the Wild. But we have options. Unbox these golden druids with his flowing green hair. Very nice. So we'd really like, I think, this next turn to get a Violet Teacher proc, and ideally he kills the Nerubar Weblord, and we just Power the Wild a shit ton of stuff. Let's see what happens here. Alright, looks like he's going to go for the Weblord. Perfect, exactly what we want to have happen. Exactly what's needed. And then the trade there makes me think that he's going for... Oh, Execute, okay. Let's see. Because of the Execute, I think I'm going to drop a Druid of the Claw. Yeah, I'll go ahead and drop a Druid and swing in here so I get some more tokens out on the board. We'll drop this guy. Let's see. You know, I think because our board's kind of empty, we don't want him in charge. This may be a mistake to play him in his taunt form, but he seems to trade really, really, really well in taunt form here. Or we can charge. Our Violet Teacher is dead, so we need more stuff on the board. We need sticky stuff. So if I don't do this, I can... Actually, we're going to go ahead and play in charge. That way we can clear two things here. So we'll go ahead and clear the Armorsmith first. Got some tokens. Awesome. Knock this guy out. Excellent. It's looking okay. Plays a taunt. I have the Cheapo Depot. Infuriating Black Knight. So again, we'd really like to get a dank-ass Power of the Wild out there. Okay. That's okay. What does he have for the Charger, though? Unstable Ghoul, alright. Well, I don't really like Power of the Wilding, these two small things. But I think it's what's necessary given the fact that there's a ghoul out. So, he's going to draw two more cards. It just has to happen, I believe. Actually, maybe Black Knighting into this would be okay. Black Knight gets another meaty guy out. Alright, so what are our options? We can Power the Wild, in which case the board stays alive because we're going to swipe. And that's our turn. We'll end up with a 4-1. Yeah, I think that even though it burns one of our oh-so-precious tokens, this is going to be the right play. I don't think Control Warriors run that many big taunts. So we'll get him burn this here. We'll lose a token. That's fine. He draws two cards. Oh well. Now, next turn we have the option of dropping a Druid to the Claw again, and then Power of the Wilding. Or Lotheb and Power of the Wilding. Power of the Wilding, it's hard to say. So I know it's probably pronounced Lotheb, but I really like Lotheb. I really like the pronunciation. He burns another Execute here, that's perfect. Okay. So it's looking like we're going to go Druid, Power of the Wild. Shield Slam. Alright. So, Druid Power of the Wild keeps our stuff alive. And keeping stuff alive is important. So, we're going to go ahead and drop another Druid in charge mode. Ooh, does that help at all? Does the Innervate help? Don't think so. It allows us to get out a big Cenarius. Is the big Cenarius worth it? You know, I think it is, because Cenarius in the next turn, Power of the Wild, is really, really, really strong. What sucks is that he can armor up and just kill our Cenarius, but at least we'll have some tokens out. So I'm going to go ahead and just try it. So if he armors up and shield slams my Cenarius, then I at least have two 2-2s out. And I can still, these two 2-2s out, drop a Druid of the Claw, Power of the Wild for a lot of stuff. This song seems a little bit louder. I'm going to turn it down a tiny bit. Alright. I did a test video and the music is really quiet, but it sounds like that song is just a little bit louder. So, we're expecting an armor up shield slam or an execute on the Cenarius. If he doesn't play Cenarius, then he's real close to dead. I know he's at 36 life and it's going to take a couple turns to beat him all the way down, but it would just be a slow process him dying. He could brawl, but I don't know if you can play around brawl with a combo deck like this. Don't know if you can. Well, because of the brawl, do we want a Lotheb? Lotheb, Power of the Wild, it gets us around. Okay, I like that. So we'll Lotheb to, so his brawl will cost more mana than he has next turn. So we drop the Lotheb. Drop the Power of the Wild. And we're feeling okay. We'll hit his little dude here. Pop him in the face. Alright. So this is a board. This is a board. Power of the Wild next turn would be nuts. I don't even know what the cost on Brawl is. I think it's 5. There we go. Yeah, it's 5, so he would need 10 mana to cast it because of Lotheb's Battle Cry. Oh, you see, I thought in the guide it says there's no Battle Cries in the whole deck, but Lotheb has a Battle Cry. It's alright. He's probably the only one in the deck that has a Battle Cry. Maybe Colma just miswrote it or miscounted. Who knows? Alright, come on, dude.
What now?
Oh, control games. Not worried about that. Not worried about that at all. I wonder why he killed the injured one. It's an interesting choice. So we have 15 damage here. I really don't want to play into a brawl. I really don't. This is the only minion I have in hand. If I had another minion in hand, I would probably go ahead and play this druid. But the fact that I don't, I feel like doing 15 damage this turn is good enough. And now if he spends next turn popping a brawl, he only has 4 mana for other plays. And a brawl, if he brawls now with none of his creatures on the board, it's going to give us one of these back, and we're perfectly fine getting any of these minions back. I'm really confused about why he played this into the already damaged Treant. I don't get it. Yeah, and this sets us up for next turn lethal anyway. The Druid of the Claw would have just made it lethal-er. More lethal. More lethal than lethal. New Rob Zombie song. Alright, might see another shield slam here. Actually, he can't slam any of my stuff. If he swung into the Treant, he could. Oh, jeez. Yeah, he's just real scared. But that dodges us another brawl. And if he doesn't shield slam this turn, he's not going to have much armor for the entire rest of the game. Innervate here kind of sucks to have. Alright, execute. It happens. That's both executes down. Now hopefully I draw a minion so I can feel better out playing this Druid of the Claw. What you gonna do, bud? Alright. That's okay with me. We're just gonna punch him right in the face. Can I still play around Brawl, or have to play into it? I think I just have to play into it. I mean, it's 2 minions. Brawl destroys one of them randomly. That's okay. We'll go ahead and armor up here again. Hit him in the face. And I have to admit, this deck feels very smooth. Very smooth, very clean. We got the Blood Mage Thalnos for the spell power on either a Wrath or a Swipe. Which means that because of the 5 damage swipe, he's lethal. We have lethal next turn if he doesn't armor up, but he's most likely going to armor up. He has a lot of cards, too. But basically, his other shield slam in his deck is now useless because he's blown both his shield blocks, and I'm not going to let him ever build up a big stockpile of armor. So I think it's okay. We're at 31 health. He's at 16. I mean, I have seen a lot of big warrior turnarounds before, but I just don't know if he can turn this one around. We still have a Force of Nature and two Savage Roars in the deck. That's a 1 in 6 chance. 18 divided by 6. 1 in 3 chance of, I don't know. Ragnaros is okay. Hope it hits me in the face. Hit me in the face. Do it. Ow, Lothab. Oh, this is good. Yeah, we have enough mana to do this, so we're going to drop the Violet Teacher. We're going to go ahead and just Wrath and draw and see what we get. Oh, wait, we got to play this too. I didn't think about that. Okay, well, wait a second. No, yeah, I drop this. Drop this guy. Okay, and then we will... Yeah, let's see. That's going to be 2, 6, 5, 7, and we're up to 6. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to draw a card. That's okay, though. We're just going to have to swipe him out. We'll innervate. Yeah. Okay. That's the play. Very close, but I'm all tapped out. I do have 2 Ancients of Lore left in the deck. Give you some card draw. That's something I don't know if this deck has very good card draw in it. Maybe that's a weakness. But I mean, it's a weakness, but we're still at this state in the game versus a very controlly deck. Baron Geddon's real shitty to see, but that just happens. I draw a card off of it at least. Ooh, okay. Ooh. I like it. So let's see. That's 3, 5, 3, 5, 6. That'd give us lethal. Yeah, so. Yeah, I got mana for this. Awesome. I think that's game. Recount, just to be sure. Okay, so 3, 4, 6. And this, yeah. That, and this gives me, yeah, okay, so let's just try it. 2 damage. Savage Roar. Boom. Perfect. Right on the cusp of being out of steam, but that game went. I think that's exactly how this deck is supposed to play. Felt good. Alright. I'm gonna turn down the game volume a tiny bit. Okay. So let's go again. We got a couple hours to play. Oh, man. So my house has 2 air conditioning units, because part of it's an addition. And the AC for our main house is busted right now. So it's not that bad because my room has a door that opens into the part of the addition where the AC is still working. But I have to have the door closed when I'm recording to keep out sound pollution. So I'm currently a fat guy sitting in my chair in just my boxers playing video games. So if you are in that state with me, I welcome you. So let's see. We want to keep a Violet Teacher. What does the Mulligan Guide say? Let's see. Innervate, Weblord, Haunted Creeper, Wrath, Power of the Wild, Harvest Golem. Well, we have the Power of the Wild. Does it say hold the Nerubar? Yeah, so we're just going to mulligan those 2. Good. Perfect opening against a Zoo deck, and this guy's most likely Zoo. Oh, wow, okay, no play. Well, in that case, God, I want to pull the trigger so hard and think it's a Zoo deck, but no turn 1 play is really suspicious, so we're going to go ahead and pass. That may be a mistake, not to coin out the Weblord or something, but Weblord doesn't really stop any battle cries from a Zoo deck. Oh, okay, so it's going to be Terror Lock, I'm assuming. Awesome, we'll go ahead and Let's see, will Nerubar block the Void Terror? Let's see. Void Terror is what he's going to need. Yeah, Void Terror is a Battle Cry effect, so we will go ahead and play out the Weblord. And that gives him just about no way to activate that egg. And it gives us the option next turn of Quaining and silencing it. Okay, that's fine. Huh, okay. Not ideal, but what did he lose? He lost a Dark Iron Dwarf from that. That's great. He lost one of his activators. Which I don't think matters, because we're just going to kill a 4-4 for free here. Next turn I'll have 4 mana. I can Haunted Creeper Power of the Wild. Okay. So we'll silence this thing. Makes his eventual Void Terror play much less strong. Happy to see a Soulfire get burned on a 2-mana drop. And he lost the Dark Iron Dwarf for it. Nerubar basically traded for 2 cards, one of them being a Dark Iron Dwarf. Perfectly okay with that. Knife Juggler. Okay. So I think, that's good to see. I think we're just going to keep battling for board control here. I wonder if Harvest Golem is the correct decision here. I don't know, this uses my mana more efficiently. There we go, I like that play. We'll go ahead and trade here. Alright. Well, if he wants to clear, he either has to use a spell or use his board. Defender of Argus would be rough here. Voidwalker. Huh. He's going for the juggle, he's not getting it. We can't... Oh, okay. Well, we can't Black Knight. Which is bad. Does Savage Roar help me here? Savage Roar helps me clear. Savage Roar Hero Power lets me clear pretty well. Yeah, I think we just have to clear. I'm feeling pretty free about burning this Savage Roar because we have another one in hand. And then I think we'll go ahead and just kill this. And we'll knock him down a little bit. It's unfortunate. Warlock's is always pretty a hard matchup, though. Let's send a message real quick. Oh jeez, that's scary. Well, Warlock is just a hard matchup always. Savage Roar wouldn't clear it. Gives me 5 damage total. Jeez, this is rough. Yeah, I have no way of clearing that. So I think we just drop our token generators and we just gotta hope for the best. He has 9 damage next turn. If he top decks a another Doomguard or a Soulfire, we just lose. But it's okay. I try to not get that tilted, losing to Warlocks. It still happens from time to time. Warlocks just feel very, very strong and steady. Okay. Hopefully no Soulfire. Oh, that's game. That's probably game. Let's see. So we Black Knight and kill this. We can kill that, and he still has 7 damage on the board. If I swipe, he still has way too much damage. I can't Black Knight and Savage Roar. I could swipe in Savage Roar. Does that save me? Let's find out. Okay, so we're gonna swipe this. Okay, we're gonna put out the second Savage Roar. And yep, that's lost, because we're just gonna swing here, and then he has lethal on board. Yeah, we'll go ahead and just put in the whole effort. And then we'll concede. Give him the well played. A bit too fast for me, I think. A bit too fast. Alright, well, that's been 25 minutes of video, so I'm going to go ahead and cut this segment, open my door so it'll cool down a little bit, and I'll be right back.